dear students, welcome back to chemistry class. So let's continue the chapter, is matter around us pure? And today let's move to the next topic, solutions. So first of all, let's see what is this solution. Okay, so solution can be defined as homogeneous mixture of two or more substances. Okay, so solution is defined as homogeneous mixture. Okay, it is a homogeneous mixture of two or more substances. So the homogeneous mixture of two or more substances are known as what? Solutions. So many examples we can say for solutions. The basic one, that is sugar solution, then salt solution, and many examples again we can say, this lemonade, all are what? Examples for solutions. Okay, so normally we people will think a solution means it is always a liquid. That is what we will always think, solutions are always in liquid phase. But there are solutions in many other phases. There are solid solutions. Solutions can be divided again further into three. There is solid solutions, then liquid solution, and gaseous solution. Okay, so solutions are mainly in three types. There are solid solution, then liquid solution, and gaseous solution. So what is the solid solution? Always we'll heard the sugar solution, salt solution, potassium permanganate solution, like that. So all those things actually belongs to liquid state, is it? So what is this solid solution? Is there any solution, solid solution? Okay, so there is solid solution. So this alloys can be considered as alloys can be considered as an example for solid solution. So children, what do you mean by an alloy? What is this alloy? So alloy is a mixture of two or more metals. Alloy is the mixture of two or more metals. This two or more metals, when it mixed together, it have a uniform concentration throughout, same composition throughout. There is no difference in the composition from one side or in other side. It is in a uniform concentration. So that's why alloys are considered as solid solutions. Okay, so children understand, alloy is an example for solid solution. So what is this alloy means? It is the combination of two or more metals or non-metals, metals with non-metals. Okay, so let's see an example for alloy. So brass is considered as an example for alloy. Okay, it is an example for alloy. And here in this brass, the main constituents are zinc and copper. So zinc and copper are the major constituents of this alloy. Okay, so let's see the percentage of this zinc and copper in it. Zinc is in 30% and copper is present the 70%. So combining 30% zinc and 70% of copper, this alloy brass can be prepared, which is an example for what? Solid solution. Okay, and for liquid solution, all these example, the sugar solution, salt solution, lemonade, all are actually example for what? Liquid solution. Okay, now let's move to the next one, that is gaseous solution. So for example, gaseous solution, air is the best example for gaseous solution. Then obviously a question, can we consider air as a solution? And of course we can consider air as a solution, because how we have already defined this solutions, it is the homogeneous mixture of two or more substances, right? So air means what? Air is the mixture of number of gases, right? Air consists of number of gases in which major components. Major components are nitrogen as well as oxygen. Okay, so there are many other gases present in air. So we can say air is a homogeneous mixture. So since it is a homogeneous mixture, air is an example for what? Gaseous solution. Okay, so these are the different types of solution: solid solution, liquid solution, and gaseous solution. And please remember its examples too. Okay, this solution has mainly two components. Okay, so the two components are, one is solute and other one is solvent. So these are the main components present in a solution, a solute as well as a solvent. So what is this solute means? The content, the component which present in less amount, the component which present in less amount is known as solute, and the component which present in larger amount, the component which is present in larger amount is known as what? Solvent. So understand, solution which consists of mainly two components, solute as well as solvent. Solute is the less amount, the component which is in less amount is called solute, and the component which is in larger amount is known as solvent. So let's consider the sugar solution. Okay, the example, sugar solution. So what are the components present in this sugar solution? It contains sugar and water. Is it sugar plus water? And just think, children, sugar or water, which we will take more? Of course, sugar will be in less amount and water we will take more. Is it? So sugar will be definitely in less amount. So sugar can be considered as an example for solute, and water is in more amount. So water is the solvent in this sugar solution. Okay, at the same time, just imagine salt solution. Salt we will take in small amount. So salt is the solute and water is the solvent. And in potassium permanganate solution, potassium permanganate, very minute quantity we are taking. So that potassium permanganate is the solute and water is considered as what? Solvent. Okay, so just understand the main components of solution: solute and solvent. Solute is in less amount and solvent is in more amount. Consider other examples for solution. So maybe it's a new term, so note down, tincture of iodine. It's a solution, tincture of iodine. So this tincture of iodine means it is an antiseptic used in wounds and all. So remember the term tincture of iodine. So this is the compound in which the components are iodine in water. So what is this tincture of iodine means? Iodine in alcohol. Sorry, iodine in alcohol is known as what? Tincture of iodine. So definitely it is a mixture, because there are more than one component is present. Iodine as well as alcohol is present. Therefore, this is an example for what? Mixture. Okay, so this is a homogeneous mixture. So this tincture of iodine, in which we have to find the solute as well as the solvent. Okay, so the components already I told you, iodine and alcohol. So here iodine is the solute. Here iodine is the solute and we can consider alcohol as the solvent. Okay, so note down the another example for this solution, tincture of iodine. Tincture of iodine means iodine in alcohol, mixture of iodine in alcohol, which is a well-known antiseptic. Okay, and next example, we can say the aerated drinks. Just consider aerated drinks. So aerated drinks means everybody know soda water. Soda water can be considered as an example for what? Aerated drinks. So in this soda water, actually what is the main component? Carbon dioxide. Okay, soda water is obtained by dissolving carbon dioxide in water. So carbon dioxide, the main component of soda water is carbon dioxide plus water. So here carbon dioxide is a gas and water is in liquid state. So here carbon dioxide we will take in less amount. So carbon dioxide is the solute here and water is in larger amount. So water is the solvent. Okay, so note down the other examples for solutions: tincture of iodine and aerated drinks. In this aerated drinks, that gas we will take, whatever may be the gas, that gas selected is the solute and the water. That means the gas is dissolved in the liquid medium. So that liquid medium can be considered as what? Solvent. Okay, so the next topic is properties of solution. Okay, so the first property of solution is a homogeneous mixture. Solution is homogeneous mixture. So that is the first property of solution. And the second one, the particles are extremely small. In a solution, the particles are extremely small. So why it is said extremely small means we can't see the particles, right? If sugar, when we will dissolve in sugar solution, means we are not able to see the particles of that sugar solution. It is already dissolved. Okay, so that means small particles, in the sense the size of the particle, the size of particles in a solution is less than 1 nanometer. Okay, size of particles in a solution is less than 1 nanometer. So what is this nanometer means? 1 nanometer is equal to 10 raised to minus 9 meter. 1 nanometer is equal to 10 raised to minus 9 meter. So just imagine the how much small the particles present in solution. Okay, so we can say this is extremely small and we can't see the particles of solution with our naked eye. Okay, and moving to the next property of solution, the particles of solution cannot be separated by filtration. Particles of solution cannot be separated, cannot separate by filtration. Last class we have studied the characteristics of mixture. There I told mixture means it can be separated by physical methods. So this filtration is one of the physical method. Okay, so by using this filtration, a components of solution cannot be separated, because when we will pass a sugar solution, when we will filter a sugar solution, means there is nothing remains in the filter paper, right? Because it cannot be separated by filtration. So note down that point also. Let's move to the fourth property of solution. Particles do not settle down. Okay, particles do not settle down, because the sugar solution, if I'm keeping for a particular place without any disturbance for 1 hour, 2 hour or whatever time, there is nothing for settling, right? Because the sugar content is already dissolved in the water, so no content is remained there for settling. So we can clearly say it do not settle down. A solution do not settle down. So solution is stable. Okay, so we can say solution is what? Stable. And in this small size of particles, here one more point we can add. So since the particles are very small, when we will pass a beam of light using a torch, when we will pass a beam of light to a glass of sugar solution or whatever, okay, to a solution, if we will pass a beam of light, a light beam is passed to this beaker in which a solution contains, the particles of solution are not able to scatter the beam of light. Okay, so if the particles are little more bigger, means they can scatter this beam of light and the path of light will be visible. But in solution, particles are extremely small, which is not able to scatter the beam of light. Therefore, the path of the light is not visible in the solution. Okay, so the fifth property we can say do not scatter. They do not scatter beam of light. Do not scatter the beam of light. So These are the major properties of solution. Their homogeneous mixture, small size, less than 1 nanometer. It cannot be separated. Components cannot be separated by filtration. They do not settle down and they do not scatter a beam of light because particles were extremely small. Okay, so these are the major things in solution. So, hope the content is clear. So, thank you all.